Hello everyone, SP Architects here. Today I want to introduce you point clouds and how can we use point clouds in ARCHICAD. In advance, I want to inform you about point clouds. Point clouds are a crucial component in the realm of 3D modeling and spatial analysis, comprising vast sets of individual data points, each representing a specific coordinate in 3D dimensional space. Point clouds offer a detailed and accurate representation of the geometry of real-world objects or environments. Integrating ARCHICAD with point clouds is essential for architects seeking precision and real-world content in their designs. Point clouds offer detailed and accurate representation of existing conditions, allowing architects to work within the context of actual environments. So, let's come and see together how can we achieve this with ARCHICAD. Alright, here we are in ARCHICAD and at the very first we are going to reach our point cloud files and import them. So, first we will go to File menu, we go to Interoperability and here we have Import Point Clouds. Let's click that and see what we have. Here I have reached our point clouds files. We have recorded each floor with different files. We have attic, basement, first floor and ground floor. We are going to import them and merge together. Let's start with the ground floor. Click open. After that you will see this window. From here you can change the object name. And here you can see which folder will be generated for LCF files. Now we have two options here. We can create or we can create and place. Let's click that and place that. Now it's loading. And after loading process, we will see this window. It says place point cloud origin at the project origin. Or we can select this point cloud origin location manually. This step is important because your point cloud origin may be different position from far away from your project and it can cause some problems. So to make sure, I will just place that file manually and place that in the center of the screen. Since we have imported the ground floor, our home story will be ground floor too. Alright, let's check it out what we have. Let's hit the M and measure some distance to make sure your scale is correct. We have a window here. Let's hit the M and see that distance. It's 90, so it's a normal distance for a window. Now we are sure our scale is correct. Let's hit the F3 and in the 3D window, we will see our point cloud. Here we see a building with shops in the ground floor. You can use your measure within the 3D window too. Let's hit the M and from here to here, it's 140. So it's a true distance. Let's go to floor plan. Here we are in the ground floor and if we go to story 1, we will see nothing. So we must be sure we won't see this point cloud in the first story too. If you see your point cloud in the first floor too, you will need to change its visibility settings. From the settings, you will see this show on stories. You will select this home story only and make sure your home story will be selected to its correct floor. So in this station is ground floor. Let's check out our heights. I'll go to waist elevation. Right click, click open with current view setting. And here we will see our ground model elevation, elevation line, this blue line, and our building 0 point, which is here. We have a sidewalk here. The distance between the sidewalk and our 0 point is 23 centimeters. But here you can also see the 0 point of the point cloud and that 0 point matches with the door elevation. So it seems correct. If it wasn't correct, you could change the elevation of the building by selecting it and hitting Ctrl+9. And here you could import your correct value and elevate your building according to that distance. Alright, this was the first ground floor. Let's import our first floor too. File, Interoperability, Point Cloud Import. Let's click our first floor and click Create and Place. Specify Point Cloud manually and first story. Here we are in the 3D window and we see that they are not matched correctly because this first floor's project origin starts with the zero coordinate. In ARCHICAD it must be in the first story, but in the real world its coordinate must be at the zero, and it's going to be same with the first ground floor. Therefore we will match them manually. Let's click this ground floor and see its elevation from the zero point. It's minus 58. Let's select this and make the value the same. We have selected the ground floor. Let's go to settings. And here to project 0 will be minus 58. The same value. Just make sure its home story will be first story. And floor plan display will be home story only. So that model will start from the 0 point. But actually its elevation will be at the first story. Alright, there we have matched their elevation correctly. Now we will match them horizontal. To do that we will go to ground floor and here we click our model and we will see this zero coordinate. I will just click this point and move it to the zero. Just like this. Now we will make the same for the first floor. After changing its position, if we go to 3D window, we will see that they are also matched. As you can see, matching them one by one is a very hard process. So instead of placing them one by one, we can place them all in once. Now let's try that too. By the way, I want to mention that these are IR prepared point cloud scans. Achieving this stage requires professional help and a powerful PC, as raw point cloud data is too large and demanding for an average computer. Team4beam.com can assist in resampling and preparing point clouds when scans are done correctly using their hardware and software. Let me introduce you Team4beam, the sponsor of this video. In challenging projects where navigating through complex architectural designs becomes overwhelming, their highly skilled team is ready to support you in all stages of ARCHICAD, Revit, and BIM constructions and designs. They are a team of certified freelance architects, ARCHICAD, AutoCAD, drafters, and technicians. Their goal is to help you to boost your productivity, expanding your drafting and BIM modeling capabilities by outsourcing drafting services to them. They are using the most advanced architectural CAD BIM software and their aim is to provide quality service of designing, drafting, and object modeling at a low price. They just provide an upfront quotation on the complete project, so you will know the total cost without any surprise. If the project is open-ended, then the standard hourly rate will apply. Either way, you are in control of the cost upfront, so no surprise. I will add a link in the description, so you will be able to reach their website. Here we are in the ground floor. Let's go to File again, Interoperability, Point Cloud Import, and I will select all of them except Basement. We can change their file again if you want. Here it is loading, and this time we will try this Place Point Cloud Origin at Project Origin. It's going to be way more faster. There we go. Here it is what we have. Let's go to 3D window. And here we can see all of the building. But the problem is the screen is too slow. I can't even move the window. It's a very big problem. To work precisely, we need to separate this building with different layers and work one by one. Let's go to ground floor. Hit Ctrl plus L. Let's create a new layer and call this ground floor. Let's create another first floor and attic. Let's click OK. Click this. Go to settings. And from here, let's make this ground floor. After that, we will click this override floor and increase this layer So we will see these points. With that, our working process will be faster. Or even I want to see only window level, I will make this 150 and make this 110. Now this seems clearer and I can move the windows faster. Let's make the same for all models. We cannot see the first story here because we didn't set up its visibility. We will go to 3D window, select that floor plan. We will select that first floor and change the floor to first story. Let's click here. Ground floor disappeared because we changed its layer and its layer is invisible in this visibility. After selecting this, we will go to its settings and let's make the same. Let's make this 150 and make this 110. Home story only, and we will just copy this to project 0, home story to first story, and paste here to project 0 once again. So with that, we won't change its elevation, but its home story will be changed to first story. By the way, since we have opened this window, we can change its layer too. Let's search our first floor, click that, and click OK. Just like that, and the rest is the same. Go to settings, override 150, 110, home story only, copy, second story, and paste. Let's change to layer 2, attic, click OK, and it will disappear. Now you can open that layer which you want to see from Ctrl plus L, and let's say that you want to see the first floor or ground floor. Open that and click OK. Alright, let's go to the first story, open our layer. There we can see our floor plan, we can see our walls, doors, furnitures, and other elements. Now all we need to do is modeling the doors, windows, and walls. For instance, let's click wall tool, change the structure to simple. As you can see, it will automatically snap to the point. And I think the wall thickness is 25 or maybe less. And we will just follow that wall trails like that. I think this is a column. And after that we can place our slab. Let's hit the space and fill inside, offset, change the structure to simple, and maybe we can create another slab to here. Just like that, let's place some interior walls. There we go. After finishing walls, we can place our doors. In this part, you can be precise as much as you want. Let's place our windows, and the important thing is checking the real photos and checking all of the point cloud data in the 3D and being as much as precise. This is just a simple model. If you do not have a good computer and a strong team, you may have great difficulties in projects like this or larger. As you can see, it's a very long and laborious task. Alright guys, as you can see, I have handed over this unfinished project to the team for Beam and they have finished it for me. And by using ARCHICAD with good some efforts, you will get your ARCHICAD project and then you can continue for your next designs. Alright guys, that's all it for this tutorial. I hope you have enjoyed it. Do not forget to hit the like button. If you have any questions or suggestions, please let me know in the comment section below. Thank you for watching. Until next time, have a nice day. Bye.